I'm an outlaw. My crime? Being poor. I, or I should say we, have taken over empty houses to live in, stolen thrown away food and eaten it, gotten used clothing and wore it, and for these simple acts of survival, the city of Philadelphia throws us in jail. I can't show you my face or tell you my name because I gotta keep on doing all these things and more. But I can show you me and my friend's story. The story of those of us on the edge of survival.
Can you put your hand on the dashboard, please?
I never wanted to break the law, to steal, to be an outlaw. So here's how it happened. I grew up here. Outsiders call this neighborhood the Badlands, but its real name is Kensington. Kensington, North Philly. I worked in factories all my life, from the age of 14 up. I mean, all them factories is gone. They're abandoned shells. Instead of working in them, people who have nowhere to go now sleep in them.
What kinds of t-shirts?
I went to my first meeting of the Kensington Welfare Rights Union. And as I got to know the other women, I saw that my situation was happening to them too. When I first went out with Sherry and Debbie, I was pretty shy. Because when you're in poverty, you lose a lot of things about yourself. I really didn't want to talk to strangers, but Sherry encouraged me.
I'm from the Kensington Welfare Rights Union. Have I met you before?
No.
She had already been through living in the streets. She lived in a car at the age of 16 years old. She was pregnant, no job, nowhere to turn. That's not something that anybody can teach you.
Trying to stop the cuts. For poor people.
It's hurt that you have inside from the pain that you've been through, you know? And anger that you have inside you. She lived it. She's the one who got us started. We went out on the street, we asked, are you on welfare? Automatically, people say, yes, I am. So we asked from there, would you like to join us in order to fight welfare so you could get more money, clothing for your children, better health care and stuff like that? We knocked on doors, we went inside stores, we did all kinds of things. I guess what really united us more than anything was that we were all poor. Sherry was having a really hard time supporting herself and her son. She had got laid off from her city job and just got a divorce.
Mother's secret stash.
I don't have any other choices. I gotta pay rent. I gotta do something.
You know, like in the Wizard of Oz, she had ruby red slippers. And these are my magic slippers. The gas is off already, and it's the 18th, and I haven't paid rent. And it's now up to these magic slippers tonight.
It hurt when I learned Sherry had to dance in a strip joint to keep a roof over her family. It made me so mad. We're living in a land of plenty. There's no reason for a good human being having to go out there and do what she has to do. We'd got a donation of some money, so we moved into a new office. Now poor people who needed something right away can find us.
Up and out, baby, up and out.
And I was feeling better, big time. It's like, all of a sudden, you got people that care about you, and you're starting to care about these people. And you become like family.
Stop killing us! Stop the cuts! Stop killing us! Stop the cuts!
This was my first demonstration, right down the avenue, past my neighbors and friends. I was really scared, but excited too. There was our target, the old boarded up welfare office, which we were going to turn into a community center for the kids. Then things started to go wrong right away. Was I going to jail for life? Would I ever see my kids again? How would they ever live without me? I was kind of surprised that they arrested us at all. But what was really scary was when they threw the book at us. Breaking and entering and criminal conspiracy. We faced 10 years in jail. 10 years for what? Trying to set up a community center?
WCAU-TV, Philadelphia. This is Channel 10 News.
They're calling it a witch hunt tonight. A group of Kensington women say that they're being harassed by police for taking over an abandoned public building.
Too hot, no air. Loud fan in a big tin can, wait here. Steer clear. They've gone to get your man. 10 a.m. through gate 3 with a picture ID.
It's been exactly 1 year since we tried to take over the welfare building, and people in Kensington have gotten to know us. Soon we can teach them what's going on, and then they teach another one. Each one, teach one. We decided to try again for a youth center.
Today, we would like to claim this abandoned building as the community center that could be fixed.
Then our kids ain't gonna be able to go to school.
We got no problems as it is here now. We don't need no more.
Some of the neighbors seemed kind of confused about what we were trying to do.
I lived here for 33 years. The cops don't do shit for us.
But you know, they're just as bad off as us, and their kids are hungry too. What we're trying to do is have a group where blacks, whites, you know, everybody can get up and out of poverty together. This is what civil affairs tried to stop. First, they collect info. Then they get DHS or welfare to check up on us or search for warrants or tickets. They even try to pressure some women to leave the group. We didn't know it then. But later that night, the civil affairs cops would come in and arrest the 8 of us who remained in the building. But the city, not wanting another public trial that made them look bad, recognized the growing strength of the Kensington Welfare Rights Union and traded us homes for 3 families if we gave up this abandoned building. We accepted.
Let's go!
Unfortunately, our phone's been cut off, and our rent fell too many months behind, so we lost that nice office. A lot more of us got notices that our welfare cases were under investigation and could be closed. Hey, we're not stupid. It wasn't only us. Now, when people lost their jobs, there would be no welfare for them. For the first time, I went down to our nation's capital. We figured if we could just make them listen. So after making enough trouble, finally Sherry got to testify to Congress. And there's one thing I'm sure you've noticed. If there's a decision to be made affecting the lives of poor people, you can be sure that there are no poor people for miles around.
We will finish with Sherry Honkla.
Hi, my name is Sherry Honkla. I am a welfare recipient, a human being, and I can speak for myself. When I was a teenager, I had to leave my home because of violence in my family. Since I had no income, I couldn't pay my rent. I was evicted. I had to sleep in my car every night.
I couldn't pay my
then
rent.
Then a drunk driver hit my car, and I became homeless on the streets and stayed in a series of shelters. Finally, in my last trimester, I became eligible for AFC benefits.
I couldn't pay my rent. Education.
The only help we would be offered is foster care or a group home for my child. And over my dead body, will I let my child be taken from me just because I'm unemployed or on welfare? I know women who have been forced.
I'm sorry, I have to cut you off. You've told a very poignant story.
Don't they understand what we're trying to say? Don't they understand our kids are hungry?
I had no laundry soap and no money. So my sister Millie let me do wash over her house today. Bemba was hungry, so I went in her refrigerator to get milk because he asked me for cereal. All that was there was one egg broken to a bowl. So I gave Bemba some dry cereal, and he was happy with that. I think everybody is struggling to eat.
When you can't get food for your kids, it can make you sort of crazy. Started walking. I sort of knew what path I was on, and it wasn't the right path, but I couldn't seem to stop. I thought about killing myself. But in the end, it was the kids, knowing I could never leave them. But what kind of world have I brought them into? That's when I knew I was gonna go further and do things I'd never done before. We called them projects of survival. Our first project of survival came just in time. 'Cause without welfare, it wasn't too long before I couldn't pay my rent. Me and the kids started camping out on this lot with other people from the union. The shelters were full up, and no one in their right mind would want their kids in those hell holes anyway. This empty lot was city land, so why not use it?
There you go, get it. Go get it.
Out here, we have to fight the city for every little thing, like this hydrant. How many of us are going to be using fire hydrants for showers? If you're not cut off welfare yet, you will be.
Hi, mi nombre es Olga, y yo estoy aquí porque yo no tengo casa, y yo estoy aquí para ayudar a otros, al igualmente ayudarme yo misma. Negro americano, blanco americano, hispano, de toda raza, porque esto no es de raza ni de colores, esto es de humanidad.
At dawn, people stir quietly, get up, and then the worries come rushing back. How will we eat today? Only some of us still had food stamps, and that only went so far anyway. So we organized our next project of survival. If you go down to the terminal market real early in the morning, you can get some good food. When you see the size of the place, you know you're living in the land of plenty. The food that's a little old, it's perfectly good, only they can't sell it, so they're supposed to throw it out. But we found a security guard who agreed to look the other way. This is the inside of my car. And as you can see, all of these beautiful strawberries were just ready to be thrown away, but we saved them. Getting the food back to Tent City was not so easy. I keep praying that the cops don't stop us because we've got borrowed plates, fake registration, and insurance from a company that doesn't exist. One of our new members helped us make them all, and that's what keeps us mobile. Our little community was very solid. But I got to admit, out here in the open, the heat, the rain, bee bites all around, all the obstacles put in our path made life harsh. Worst of all was how the city was trying to destroy us. They finally struck at our most vulnerable, the children. Saying that living conditions were unacceptable for the children, DHS took Naomi's 5 kids.
They brought in their child advocates, and she started saying that where I was at wasn't fit for my children to live in because my son Jeremy, that's 3, has asthma.
What happened?
We're gonna fight this together, okay?
We'll get your help. We'll come back home to your mom.
They're just kids. But they gotta be separated away from their moms. Just because we don't got no home, we here, we okay here. And they feel so bad about us. Why they not helping us? Why they just coming out taking our children away? They ain't got no right to do that.
And now my children are taken away from me for 10 days that I have to go back August the 4th to fight for them. And have a house by that time, too. So I want to see how I'm going to do that.
Naomi never got her children back. Shortly after they were taken from her, we lost Naomi to the streets. And to heroin. As the weather got cooler, rats the size of cats started coming in for the warmth. Our time at Tent City was drawn to a close.
We want you to hear our prayer today.
We had to find shelter indoors, and we were going to have to do it secretly.
We have been here for over 2 months now.
I was raised upright, not to steal or take what wasn't mine. So now we pray together to get the strength to do something which goes against how we were raised up, to take what we need to survive. So we made a plan. We called it Operation Underground Railroad, to remind ourselves that it was okay to break the law to live. Escaping from slavery used to be against the law, too.
In the Lord's house.
So now you know why they call me an outlaw. I am one of the women you have just seen, and I am all of them. My story is made up of bits and pieces of our true lives. With every passing day, it's harder to get food and shelter. More of us have less and less. The cops may be able to stop some of us. But they can't stop all of us. We're not going to disappear. Are you out there in other cities doing the same kinds of things we are to survive? If so, remember, as we say in Kensington, North Philly, you only get what you're organized to take.